I wasn't living right. Lie awake for over half the night. I know that I was in.
Back at 25. We're just going to do three recipes that it's like a really easy snack to do. Using the local ingredients, using the coconut, the navara, and the banana. Now, you can see, if you've been to the market, they do the taro chips, is that right?
Yes.
Kumula chips?
Kumula chips, manioc chips.
Manioc chips, yeah. So what we're going to do now is we're going to do the banana chips. So we've got the plantain banana, big fella banana, and then we're going to peel it. And then we're just going to deep fry that, and then we're going to make a nice curry salt. So instead of just using salt and pepper, I thought we'd chuck some curry powder in there to make it a little bit more tasty. So there's one snack. The other snack is the
dry coconut.
The dry coconut. It's like roasted. So we're gonna cut it. Anne Rose is gonna cut it for you, and then she's gonna. Are you sticking?
Yes.
Sticking. So Bailey's sticking, which means that she'll cut the flesh out into nice strips, and then we will deep fry that. And again, with some salt and pepper, delicious. And then we're gonna use the navara. Now, there's another episode on this, but. This is the last stage of the coconut. So we've got the green coconut, we've got the dry coconut, and then we've got the navara. So as you can see, this is already starting to sprout to become another coconut tree. If it's left long enough in the ground, the roots will start appearing. So in here, we'll cut it open, you can have a look. The liquid has turned into like a foam. It's like, what do you say, like marshmallow? It's soft, it's round, it tastes like coconut.
Sweet and nice.
Yeah. And pecanines? Or pecanines, okay?
Yes, cook a pecanine. We have some more fruits.
Yeah. And it's just a snack, isn't it?
Yes. Yeah. You have some nuts or?
Yes, like really soft.
Dry.
Dry. Yeah. I would call it marshmallow, she calls it a mattress. However you want to call it, but that's what it tastes like. And what we're going to do there is just, again, it's a snack for the Ni Vanuatu. Usually they go along the bush and they grab it and they cut it open and then they eat it. We're just going to tart it up a little bit with the Heitu Daka.
So. I have a deep fryer, so it's really easy to just use a pot and some oil and just heat it up really gently. Don't put on full speed, full fire. So it's over there. The best way to test it is that you drop one piece in, and if it starts sizzling, like lightly sizzling, then you're good to go. If it doesn't sizzle, it's not ready, wait for it to sizzle. And if it's like really, really, really hardcore sizzling, it's far too hot. That's pretty much how you can tell. You just want it just sizzling nice.
The thinner you cut the banana, obviously the less time it takes to cook, and the more crispy it can get. So look at these are like real paper thin. Again, thin, crispy. So what I've done is I'm going to mix a little bit of salt with a little bit of curry powder and a little bit of pepper. Go with the salt first. Go with the pepper. If you're using your fingers, do the curry last. Saves you getting curry inside the salt when you're doing it. So curry, last one.
Felt the pull of the lower thigh. Is anybody really satisfied? I don't care. I want the world to treat me fair. And you know, I'm aiming up.
Alright, so the navara. Again, this is the last process of the coconut. And it's got, you can buy it at the market all tied up like this. This part here determines how old or how young it is. The shorter it is, the stem, it's not quite ready. The longer it is, it's getting overripe and sour. So you want it about under half a meter long. Is that 30 cm? A ruler long? And then you'll know that it's sweet and ready to go. I actually don't know what the English name is, but I might Google it and put it down there somewhere. Okay, so what we're gonna do, really easy. It's quite firm to cut, but like an apple, okay? And that's it, like, see, like, it's firm but soft, spongy, like polystyrene. That's not really a good explanation, but it's that type of, cut that bit out, okay. All right, so
I like it.
Hey?
I like it.
Okay, my dish. So again, a snack. Like I said, the guys just eat it like this. But we're going to make it a little bit interesting. I place this in a salad. This is really nice with a pumpkin salad. We do it at K2. It's roasted pumpkin, navara, dakka, balsamic, and crispy island cabbage. K2 dakka. This is made from our local nangai nut, which is like the island almond. So in that, there's fennel seed, cumin seed, black pepper, and nangai nut, and salt. All right, to give it a bit of a bite, some spring onion. And we mix it up. Again, best tools of the kitchen are your hands, as long as they're clean. Not too much olive oil because it does the navara will soak it up.
I met you when I wasn't right.
You can see. So I'm gonna finish and go to fry it, then we can look nice by crunchy small.
So with the coconut, because it's cut a little bit thicker, it'll take a little bit longer, is that right, Amrose? Loitan. Yeah. So you want it nice and golden brown.
Oh yeah. That's the winner. Alright, Amrose is getting the coconut out.
Yeah, just move it.
Delicious. It's nice and golden brown. Nutty, fried, fatty, oily. Smells like popcorn. Crunchy. What should we put on that? Should we put salt and pepper on that? You reckon?
More salt, more pepper?
Just a little bit, I reckon. Oh yeah, smell that. Can you smell that? It smells like popcorn.
I lost the fight, the war. It was a raging inside. But now I got so much to give. I figured out how I want to live. And I got to aim it up high. Yeah.
Okay, so Amrose is like plating this beautiful golden brown coconut.
Short team.
Does that look good?
Nice, very nice.
Very nice. All right, do you want to tell us what we've done? Amrose, tell everyone. What have we done?
Okay. We save the side of a nice plate with like, make it, make coconut, it's colorful and it's brownie and it's nice. It smells, because it's crunchy. And it's simple pan now with like cheese, make it. So it's like rolling island cabbage. And it pan straight, it's like milk for coconut. Cream and talem, any nice. And then Enya, any nafara salad, just mix nut, contalem, spring onion, and taka, olive oil, and just garnishing coconut, nafara salad. And yeah, last one, any banana chips. It colorable, any yellow, any nice. We do like putum road deep fryer. Emmy, nice and crunchy.
Would you eat that?
Yeah.
You think you could you eat this? I reckon. Do you think they could eat this? Do you reckon people at home could make this in roast?
Yes, Emmy, so easy. Yeah? So she'd like follow up with me to love it, like catch up.
Yeah, I reckon. So guys, so that's it. Real easy snacks. How long did that take? Like 10, 15, maybe 20 minutes, say, to get all that ready. If you have it in your cupboards, salt and pepper you have in your cupboards. I'm sure everyone has curry powder, everyone has olive oil. Everyone should have K2 dakka in their pantry. Coconuts, yeah, if you can't grate a coconut, ask somebody to help you to grate a coconut or open the navara like I had needed help. Fresh dry coconuts from the market, the navara from the market, the banana from the market. As you know, in Vanuatu there's markets everywhere. They're all around the streets. Main market in town, Munplace Market, Freshwater Market, There's markets everywhere. Again, easy snacks, healthy, local, fresh. Can you say buon appetito? Buon appetito.
Put me on the phone to God. There's a mountain I should climb. I'm here to take what is mine. I'm aiming, aiming up.
Oh,